Good morning, everyone. My name is Alex Dodds. Welcome to episode 50 of Dodds Diaries. Today is Friday, the 29th of January. Oh, and I know it is quite late, but a very happy new year to you all. Welcome to another year of train videos. This is my 10th year. And welcome to another year of Dodds Diaries. Well, today, the first diary of the year, it's a big one for 2016. This is my 10th year, and today is my 50th diary. And for my 50th Dodds Diary, I am going on a mega-long 900-mile journey around the UK. Well, it's going to be an estimated somewhere around there. I'll catch the bus to Newcastle, and then I'll explain more about it when I get there. Now, unfortunately, today I am going to have to travel through a storm. Storm Gertrude is up in Scotland. Well, that's one part where I'm going. So I'll have to go through that. And also the journey, there's going to be a slight alteration to when I mentioned this at the end of last year. Let's enjoy today. I'm at the bus stop. It's waiting for the 5 o'clock bus to Newcastle, which is due in about 4 minutes. Now, in case you didn't know, I am using yet another new camcorder. Now, I have been out to a few places already and tested it, and I can tell you that this camera is absolutely fantastic. I am now using the Sony HDR-CX405. Beforehand, it was my Samsung F70. This new camcorder is absolutely fantastic, and in the dark, it picks up the shots better than what the old camera did.
Okay, everyone, going northeast, right Gemini 2 hybrid, number 6065 on the 21.
continue to annoy Nexus, the Metro, for a few moments. I'm now at Newcastle Central Station. It's now 5 to 6. So, today's journey. It's going to be an estimated 900 miles in total that I'm going to be travelling. Firstly, we're going to get the 0622 Virgin East Coast to Edinburgh Waverley. We're due there at 8:05. Now, fortunately, as it's in here, gale force winds. Unfortunately, up in Scotland, Storm Gertrude is battering that part of the country, so I have to travel into that. When I get to Edinburgh, I might do some filming, depending on the conditions. Then after Edinburgh, I'll be going over to Glasgow Queen Street on a ScotRail Class 170 Turbo Star. I'll be in Glasgow just for a little moment. I'll be meeting up with Jake and Ryan. Now, here's the interesting thing. I was going to be going from Glasgow Central straight down to London Euston on the 1340 service. Unfortunately, as you know, at Christmas, the country was battered by a Storm Frank. And on the West Coast Main Line, Lamington Viaduct, south of Carstairs in Lanarkshire, was severely damaged. So there's no trains running between Carlisle and Glasgow. Except, however, there is a Voyager, Virgin Voyager, diverting train every hour from Glasgow Central to Carlisle via Dumfries. I have an advanced ticket, but I will be able to get that train. Then at Carlisle, I then should be able to get straight onto the train to London Euston. Yes, for the first time, I am going at least all the way down that most of the West Coast main line. The Carlisle to Glasgow bit, I can maybe just do that on another video diary. So get to London this evening about 5:10 or 6:10, depending on if I can use my ticket on the first train I can get. When I get to London, I'll hang around there for a number of hours, and then I'll come back from King's Cross on the 10 o'clock train. Remember the train I got from King's Cross back in April last year? Well, that's the one I'm getting again this year. Then I get that train, be back up here, 2 o'clock in the tomorrow morning, get the night bus home. I'm not going to be home until about 3 o'clock tomorrow morning, and I've been out of bed since nearly 24 hours. I'm going to be out of bed. Today should be very, very exciting, very challenging as well. I think the first challenge is just to try and get through Scotland during Storm Gertrude. But anyway, let's enjoy today. Disaster. The train's been cancelled. Unfortunately, Storm Gertrude has bit back and severe overhead wire problems at Berwick upon Tweed. This is cancelled, and now I'm glad to get a bus replacement all the way up to there. That's going to take 2 hours. Will I get to Glasgow at least? I do not know.
This bus replacement is now going direct to Edinburgh. And to be honest, it's probably safer getting this because, for all I know, the East Coast line around Berwick may actually get cut off completely at any moment. So I'm taking no chances of getting this. Bus wise, that's a ride Gemini 2 going northeast, just leaving there. The time is now 5 to 7, well, it's just gone 5 to 7. Hopefully I can still get there in time. Off we go. Now we're going to get to the A1. I would have been stuck. Somewhere near Berwick. God knows what will happen when I get to Scotland. This is the River Tweed, just passing over. The border of Scotland is just a little further up. Scotland. outskirts of Edinburgh now. The TMD depot is somewhere around here. So as I get to Waverley Station, get the first train to Glasgow. I'm going to try and get through this storm as quickly as possible.
To Edinburgh now. It's 10 to 10. Just outside of Waverley Street. What an awful day it is. Now, will I get to Glasgow? Let's see. There's a train in Glasgow, Queen Street, which is just up here, platform number 13. Right, we've got a 170, a 158. Sadly, I've had no time to wait to open here. So, straight on to Queen Street.
I had a problem with me because I thought I would get back to the office yesterday before. Yes, I did. It was a fairly quick conversation because, to be honest, I was in a restaurant and I could hardly hear a single word. But he could just about hear what I was saying. But the thing is, this came in this year, but it was at the end of year submissions. It was on the end of year submissions of 2013. So we had.
but it does, it dries like a normal mask, and it's meant to, like, and I love it. It smells so good, and I feel so fresh.
Now approaching Glasgow Queen Street.
Everyone, for a bit of a topsy-turvy journey, I'm now in Glasgow, just walking down Buchanan Street. Look who's with us.
Hello.
Jake Neil. And we're going to get the 11:22 to I'm going to get to Carlisle. Jake's going to go as far as Kilmarnock. Go. We've got about 20 minutes to get there. And then from Carlisle onwards, I go to London. What a morning I've had, but
yeah, John, they could just get, could make it a bit even more, a bit more slower, because there's a speed restriction between Oxenholme and Penrith, both ways.
But that's only a small section, isn't it?
32 miles, reasonable.
Yeah, but that gets to, just walking. That gets to, they'll probably get to London only about 20 minutes later than usual. Right. I'll see yous later on. The weather-wise, I think the storm's starting to pass over now.
Now in Glasgow Central, I'm going to catch this train at 11:22 to Carlisle.
Jake here gets off at Kilmarnock, because this train will actually pick up, well, Does it actually stop?
Yeah, it stops there, aye.
Alright.
And look, Mr. Ryan and James. Oh, I forgot to get you a pint.
Ah, sorry.
It's alright.
Right, never too early for a boat or a tub of Neil.
Right, we'll get to Carlisle about 12:38. Let's enjoy the journey. Just playing a little bit dumb. Nice smile.
Jeez.
Okay, so we left Glasgow and for the first time I'll be having a ride on the Glasgow South West main line.
Oh, you've never been on this line, no?
Only from Carlisle to Dumfries.
Ah. at least you're going to be some great attraction.
All right.
Any other time you would have got about 5'6" or something?
Yeah.
He used to short your 156 in Newcastle.
Yeah, I've been on the early morning. Past a bar head. It's now 11:27. So where what, there's a little lake here?
It's a reservoir.
It's a reservoir.
Right, watch out. Yeah, not too sure.
Aye, it's a reservoir. I don't know the name of it, but...
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Jameson's just over there. Getting a bottle of the Tilton Ale. He's never off that stuff. Come on, get me a bottle, or get me a can, mate.
Is that your six?
Be interesting.
Is that your six?
Is that your six, seven, or eight? Or nine, or ten?
Sleep out, I'll be foaming.
So there's a Lupton single box, and there's another Voyager doing another shuttle.
So I can get the best seat when I'm on 5'8", because it's a peak hour and Eddie steals my spot.
Kilmarnock. Jake's just left us. Virgin trains will be stopping here while the diversions are on until March. That'll be when Lamington Viaduct will be repaired, hopefully. This station has got four platforms. There's a train that goes to Glasgow. How often does that run?
Every half an hour. And yeah. there's an R train that goes down to like Stranraer via air.
All right.
That's usually every 2 hours.
At the moment, there's disruptions to services in Stranraer due to the weather conditions caused by Storm Gertrude.
And that's just going on to the viaduct.
This is Kilmarnock Town Centre.
Absolutely, ladies and gentlemen, this is the manager here. Welcome to the customers joining us at Kilmarnock. It's the purchase to the Voyager to Kilmarnock.
Just passed Auchinleck. 12:15. Was a Sanker we just went through.
Yeah.
The next stop we go through will be Dumfries, and I've been there a few times before. Ryan's having fun with that, he's having teething problems with his bottle opener. This is, looks like a Dumfries that we're coming through. And if the time value lines fully reopen in February, I might consider coming up here for the diamonds. In fact, here's the station coming up now. That means now I've done the entire Glasgow South West main line. I have filmed Dumfries to Carlisle in series 3 and series 4. So there's a new line just covered. Just got to go through Annan and then Gretna Green, and then we join the West Coast main line at the border.
I used to stay with Alassie and Paisley and that, so after...
Right, it's now 13:25. We're just coming back onto the West Coast main line now, and about to cross over the border back into England. It does feel a bit strange because only this morning I was on a bus replacement going to Edinburgh. And in fact, we just passed over the border now. And I'm heading down to London. And I've just had a little quick trip in central Scotland this morning. We'll be in Carlisle in a few minutes' time. Mm. Ryan's just finishing off his tilt and nail. And then he's going back to
Glasgow
on this Voyager.
And then a 158 to Edinburgh and a HST back.
Oh, look at you, 158.
Yeah. Oh, again, it's all so
tight. We need Stockrail 158 at Hayton Depot, and we would give them our paces.
No, we can keep the 158s, but I'll give you the 380s for the pacers.
Well, if we had the 170s instead of pacers.
Oh, there we go, I'll get you the 170s for pacers.
Yeah, that would be nice. No, 158s we need at Hayton Depot.
Yes, you don't often say trains in this side as well, so it's actually a rare moment.
Is it?
Right, it's a bit. Because the stock rails always go from the next platform, so for us, kind, it's actually quite a decent moment. Okay. It's one of our favourite stations.
Do you know where I get the train for?
Where are you going, Tim? Is it
Houston?
London, yeah? In fact,
there's a train there.
Yeah, it's a train up there. Right, I'm now in Carlisle. It's now time to get on the 1346 all the way for the first time to London Euston on this Pendolino. And I will enjoy this ride.
Going to London at 5:10 this afternoon.
Hello, are you okay? Yeah, I just thought I'd give you a quick ring because I'm travelling back from Scotland. Did you get the email I sent on to you? That's fine, just... out loud, did you? Yeah, well, I think you'd offered a 10 anyway, haven't you? Originally. I think on your Excel sheet, you've offered a 10. You can see what sheets come back. Actually, their offer's quite good, because normally they try screwing you for everything. So I think it will mean... Did you work it out? I think you've got... I think it means that you need to give her another... it might be 2.5 or it might be 3. I just have to work it out.
afternoon, welcome. Passengers who join us at Wigan Northwestern. This is a slightly delayed 1509 Virgin Berlin service to London Euston. Next stop is Warrington Bankie, 10 minutes, and then we run non-stop to London Euston. Warrington Bankie, your next station call, 10 minutes to...
Leaving Warrington Bankie, and now it is non-stop all the way to London, Euston.
pass under the cross-country line at Birmingham. We're about an hour away from Euston. There's the London Overground line. It's the start of the Waverley line.
Central. Thank you.
afternoon, folks. We'll shortly be arriving at London Euston, where this service will terminate. Please be sure to have a good look around. Make sure you have all your belongings with you. And please take care when leaving the train. On behalf of the onboard team, I'd just like to thank you for travelling with us today. We do hope you had a pleasant and relaxing journey. This is London Euston. All change, please.
Tower just up there.
Right, your forks, it's now 23 minutes past 5. After a long journey, somewhere like nearly 600 miles, finally, here I am in London. Yes, I travelled to Newcastle, then to Edinburgh, then to Glasgow, then to Carlisle, and now finally I'm all the way down here. I'm at a Euston station now, straight away. We're going to do about a half an hour session here. Now, of course, while I'm down here this evening, it's only going to be a mini day out. I'll probably do this station and King's Cross and go to a couple of sightseeing places. Because and then, of course, maybe definitely later on this year, I will be here for a full day out. Now, of course, we're in Jobsworth Central, so I have to be careful, but we're all right so far. Anyway, let the few hours begin.
Lancaster, Oxford Home Lake District, Penrith for the North Lakes, and Carlisle. This train is full of 9 coaches. Will passengers intending to travel on this service please join the train now and ready to leave? Platform 15 for the 17:30 Virgin Trains service to Carlisle, which is ready to leave. Please do not leave your luggage unattended on the station. Luggage coaches.
platform 12 from the 1741 London Midland Express train.
Customers intending to travel on the 1749 London Midland service to Birmingham New Street via Northampton. Sorry to announce that the trains who operate this service are being delayed on its inbound journey this evening. The departure of this train is now expected to be delayed by between 3 and 5 minutes. Sorry that the train to operate the 1749 London Midland to Birmingham New Street via Northampton. The train has been delayed its inbound journey. The train is now expected to arrive at platform 8 in around about 8 minutes time. Very sorry for the delayed arrival of the train to operate this service today.
Platform 5 for the 1757 Virgin Trains service to Lancaster. Calling at Town. London Midland service to Northampton. Call it Parham of Newton, Watford Junction, Pebble Hempstead, Berkhamsted, Bletchley, Milton Keynes Central, Wolverton and Northampton. This train is formed of 12 coaches.
London Midland service to Birmingham New Street via Northampton. Train now expected to arrive at platform 8 in around about 3 to 4 minutes time. be trained to operate at 1749. London Midland service to Birmingham New Street via Northampton.
Okay, it's 6:15. We'll go and sign out and then we'll go and get the tube to Piccadilly Circus.
It's now gone 18 minutes past 6. Here I am at a Piccadilly Circus.
Hyundai, Coca-Cola.
There is Regent Street and there's two Boris Master buses just over there. These are the famous neon signs. Is it right? You can flip there. Over there's Shaftesbury Avenue. Yeah, we're still in Piccadilly Circus. One is there.
I'm gonna have my dinner here and then I wonder where I'll go next. I'm having an absolutely brilliant day, mate. So only this morning I was just on a bus replacement going to Scotland and here I am down here. Fantastic. And look where we are. Here it is, Big Ben. It's nearly 5 to 7. Travelled all the country today. Been to Scotland. And I've come down here. One absolutely amazing day has been. And I finally made it to here. Let's see what this camera's like at night time. Let's have a look at the Thames. It's a lot better. That's Charing Cross, just over there. The Golden Jubilee Bridge is there. There's a South Eastern train passing across. We've got a lot of river boats around. And here's the London Eye. This was only originally meant to be a temporary structure for the millennium, but it's kept for all eternity. And if we look over here, just sticking out, there's a little bit of the shard at the top. Absolutely brilliant. Fortunately today, it's only a short few hours what I'm doing here. I have to return here later on this year. This is the other side of the Thames. I'm standing on Westminster Bridge. Over there is Waterloo Bridge. This is the Houses of Parliament. In about 2 minutes, that will chime 7 p.m. So it will chime 7 times. Right, I'm now at Cannon Street. It's coming up to 7:30. I had no trouble getting permission. The Network Rail bloke wasn't here, so I had to ask one of Southeastern, but thankfully, he was kindly sound. What we've got is Southeastern trains in the platforms. We've got Tower Bridge, just over there. We've got the Shard, and look at that, lit up at night time. That is amazing. It's not evening rush, just the, towards the end of the evening rush hour. That's Pickford's Wharf over there. Just waiting for this train to draw past and we'll see what's on the other side of the Thames lit up. Home of Financial Times is over that way. Blackfriars Station, and you can actually see train leaving with the passengers as well. Yeah, there's Blackfriars over there. St Paul's Cathedral is just up there as well. This is 376-003.
New Cross, Hurlington, Seven Oaks, Hildenborough, Tunbridge, High Brooms and Tunbridge Wells. Platform 5 for the 1933 Southeastern service to Tunbridge Wells. Please do not leave your luggage unattended on the station. Luggage left unattended may be removed without warning or destroyed or damaged by the security services. This is a safety announcement. Due to today's wet weather, please take extra care whilst on the station. Surfaces may be slippery. service to Dartford. Please take extra care whilst on the station. Surfaces may be slippery. A safety announcement. Due to today's wet weather, please take extra care whilst on the station. Surfaces may be slippery.
Yeah.
It's now around 8:05. Now on one of the Golden Jubilee bridges outside of Charing Cross Station. So down there is Embankment Tube Station. We've now got a closer view of the Thames at night time. There's St Paul's Cathedral. Yeah. Of course, the Shard, that's where I was just now. Hopefully one time I will take a ride on one of the river boats here. I would love to do that. Quick look here, coming up to 8:30, and then when I'm done here I'm going to go up to King's Cross and stay there for the evening. Just have one little look at the West End area. You get a real buzz round here. I'd love to have a night out. Let's have a look. That little display looks absolutely brilliant. For all the various bars and restaurants, nightclubs, theatres, everything's all here.
Over there, there's M&M World. I have to go in there one time. Since I love my chocolate, you bet I do. Got more just here. And so when I finish, I'll get the Piccadilly line back to King's Cross. To King's Cross Station, my favourite terminus in London. My last spotting session tonight before I head back home after an epic long journey today. So I'm going to have about half an hour spotting set here. See what's in the platforms. Got a 225 there. We've got another two Virgin 225s here. Got a Great Northern. Trains down there, a couple more here. They're still in the old First Capital Connect livery. Now, I've been told a sleeper train should be due here, but there's no sign of it yet. Hopefully I may be able to film it before I go home tonight.
Thank you.
now going to go and sign out and finish. There's been no sign of the sleeper train, sadly. And I need to go to Matty D's, get some Red Bulls as well for my train home. So just like in April last year, we're getting the 10 o'clock train back up to Newcastle. And then we get the night bus, N21, from there back to Northlands in Chessy Street, which will be at 2:15. That's hopefully the train gets back for 2 o'clock in the morning. Anyway, time for me to enjoy the last part of this epic journey back to my place. I will return to London later on this year for a full day out, as I usually do every year. Right, here's my train, 2200 Virgin Trains East Coast to Newcastle. We get there at 2 o'clock in the morning.
On this 2200 Virgin train service to Newcastle, my name is Craig, and I'll be your train guard tonight. This service will be calling at Peterborough, Grantham, Newark Northgate, Doncaster, York, Northallerton, Darlington, Durham, G2-Ivan to Newcastle at 2:16. If you could please ensure your luggage is stored in the max provided, keeping all hallways and doors clear. For your safety and security, there is CCTV in operation. Safety information is displayed in the area between coaches. Wi-Fi is available throughout the train. If you start one of our two quiet coaches, coach B for Bob on the way front of the train, or coach K for Kilo in first class, please don't keep this way by switching all your electrical equipment and mobile phones to silent mode. And if you do wish to make a telephone conversation, this must be done in a different part of the train. If you do have any questions during the journey, please don't hesitate to stop and ask either myself or any other member of the team as you pass throughout the train. Further announcements regarding the availability of catering facilities will follow shortly by a member of our catering team. First call on point for the service is Peterborough, where it's due to arrive at 22:46. A full ticket examination is about to commence. If you can please hold tickets ready for inspection, and if you are moving throughout the train, please keep your tickets with you. If you do not wish to be bothered, please leave the tickets on the table in front of you. Thank you. evening and welcome aboard. Two passengers join the train at Peterborough. This is the 2247 Virgin train service to Newcastle. My name is Craig, I'll be your train guard today. This service will be calling at Grantham, Newark, Northgate, Doncaster, York, Northallerton, Darlington, Durham, due to arrive to Newcastle at 2:16. If you could please ensure your luggage is stored in the max provided, keeping all hours and doors clear for your safety and security. There is CCTV in operation. Safety gentlemen, this is a 2352 Virgin train service to Newcastle, now calling at York, Northallerton, Darlington, Durham, due to arrive into Newcastle at 2:16. Next calling point for this service will be York, who is scheduled to arrive at 38 minutes past midnight. Thank you.
Right, I'm now in York. It's now 25 past midnight. We do not go until 42 minutes past. So here we have a class 150, and we got a 155 there. These will head back to Neville Hill soon, I think. So said we do not set off to Newcastle for at least 15 minutes, so I've got time to have some fresh air.
ladies and gentlemen, and finally we are on our way from York. This is the 042 Virgin Train service to Newcastle. My name is Craig, I'm your train guard today. Service will now be calling at Northallerton, Darlington, Durham and Newcastle. We no longer have to wait a book departure time from stations. We are set down only, which means we're only dropping people off at stations now. This should speed up our journey to Newcastle. Estimated times of arrival now are Northallerton at 1 o'clock, Darlington at 1:14, into Durham for approximately 1:32, and finally Newcastle for approximately 1:46. Next call point is Northallerton, where we're due to arrive at approximately 1 o'clock. Thank you.
back up that bridge, Northlands. It's been about less than an hour. To Edinburgh. Here, back in Newcastle, it's just coming up to 2 o'clock in the morning of Saturday, 30th of January 2016. I've now got a walk to St. Nicholas Street. Which is just next to High Level. I get the N21 night bus. And I should be there. Of course, to get there, I need to get past all the boozers. To be honest though, this time of the year, there won't be that many out. Some won't get paid until Monday, I think. See what I mean? This place is wild at this time of the morning. It's absolutely wild. This bus should be due shortly. I thought I've had a couple of nights out through here, I do have a few more. We're just up there, it's the N21 night bus. It's just on its way now. Right, everyone, try and make this quick now. Back at Northlands in Chesley Street after a very, very long day, and I'm back where I started. It's now just coming up to 3:07 in the morning. It's really cold out here. Today, what an absolute wonderful day I've had. It's been an absolutely brilliant experience. I have travelled about 900 miles today, probably one of the best video diaries I've ever done out of them all. So yesterday actually, it's now a Saturday morning. We started here, bus to Newcastle,
sneaked in a Town and Wear Metro video, so a clean video of a Nexus again. And then the first train trip was going to be the 0622 Virgin East Coast to Edinburgh Waverley. Unfortunately, well, I got on the train, then a few minutes later it got cancelled. Apparently what happened was there was an electric train at Berwick upon Tweed that was going to London. Its pantograph snapped off the class 91, so that had to be taken out of service, and they needed the HST to get people from Newcastle down to London, which meant to put me and the other passengers on the other train in a bit of trouble. So what we had to do, that bus replacements were put on. There was a couple of buses for intermediate stations, and there was one put on for direct service all the way to Edinburgh. So we got on it, left Newcastle about 7:10, I think. The journey, oh, I think actually it was 7:20, the journey took 2.5 hours. The bus just simply went straight up the A1 motorway, which was actually not too bad. All in all, just made for a more exciting day out, a more exciting diary. Got to Edinburgh at 9:45. Unfortunately, because of that, it meant I've been unable to do any filming in Edinburgh Waverley or Glasgow Central stations. I'll go back to them places again, and what I might do is probably do a video diary and maybe do like a border loop. So maybe Newcastle, Carlisle, Glasgow to Edinburgh, back to Newcastle, once all the lines are fully reopened and everything's back to normal. Anyway, back to the diary. I got the 10 o'clock from Glasgow Queen Street to Northern Edinburgh Waverley. See, I'm tired. My mind's just all, it's all scrambled. Edinburgh Waverley to Glasgow Queen Street, 10 o'clock ScotRail service. As soon as I got to Queen Street, met up with Jake Neal, and met up with Ryan Jameson as well. Got the 11:22 Virgin Voyager shuttle to Carlisle. It was going down the Glasgow South West Main Line because of the damage to a Lamington Viaduct south of Carstairs, which actually gave us a chance to ride the whole Glasgow South West Main Line for the first time ever as well. I might actually consider going to Dumfries in February to film them diversions while they're still on. Jake got off at Kilmarnock, the Voyagers were stopping there, and Ryan joined us all the way at Carlisle. Now here's another thing, the advanced ticket restriction from Glasgow to London Euston was took off, which meant therefore I was able to get an earlier train from Carlisle all the way down to London Euston. I got down to London for 5:10 instead of 6:10 that was planned. I thought there was someone coming there. No, it's just the wind. So I got to London. The ride down the West Cross Main Line was absolutely fantastic. The train seemed to go much faster than what the Virgin East Coast trains go. The Pendolinos, a lot of bends in that, and obviously a lot of tilt in action. Went through places like Penrith, Oxenholme, Lancaster, Preston, Wigan, Warrington. Went through Rugeley as well. Went through Lichfield, like Tamworth, Nuneaton, Rugby, then into Northamptonshire, then back through Watford, and then into London. As soon as I got to London, I signed in at Euston Station. Absolutely no problems whatsoever. Did about 30 minute session there. Then afterwards went to Piccadilly Circus, had a look around. Then went to see Big Ben, chime at 7 p.m. Then I went to Cannon Street. Now at Cannon Street Station, the Network Rail Block was not there, so I had to ask the duty manager from South Eastern for permission. At least thankfully I managed to get a nice one, because South Eastern are known to be quite jobs worthy in London. Did 20 minutes at Cannon Street, no problems. Went to the embankment, then I went to Leicester Square, and then finished the night at King's Cross. Did about 30 minutes. filmed Grand Central coming in. Didn't get a chance to film the stop at the sleeper train, although I did pass it when I left King's Cross. Got the train, 10 o'clock, back up to Newcastle. That train does stop for half an hour at York Station. It is timetable that... a shivering would call me. It is timetable to do that. Got back to Newcastle at 2 o'clock. Got the night bus, 2:15, and now the time is 3 o'clock on the dot, and I'm back here. If I stay up another 35 minutes, I'll have been out of bed 24 hours. A whole 24 hours, God help us. 900 miles I've travelled, and I'm back here finally. Well, thank you very much for watching this long diary. Follow me on Twitter, AlexDodds4, the link is on the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. I haven't got another diary planned yet, but I'm thinking of somewhere, maybe towards the end of February. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Good night, or I should say good morning, good night, and thank you for watching.